Hi friends, I hope you are doing well where you are. Today I'm recording this video just to explain to you how to submit any application to any scholarship you need. Okay, so just follow this video, just watch this video till the very end and don't miss any second. Okay, but before that, I would like to ask you to subscribe to this channel because that's what encourages us to continue doing this job. Okay, let's go straight to the point. First step, you have to find the scholarships. For you to find the scholarships, there are many pages on the internet, but we have this our page, Scholars to Scholars, where you can find scholarships. By the way, in this page, we just post reliable scholarships. So you can follow us there. We'll keep on updating you about reliable scholarships that you can find across the world. So then you can apply. After you find the scholarship, we move to the next step where you have to check the eligibility criteria. In this step, you have to check carefully if you meet all the criteria required by the university or the scholarship program. Because if you submit your application without meeting all these eligibility criteria, then you will fail. So it's not worth for you to keep on doing something that you know that you won't be useful. Okay, you are just wasting your time, you might even waste your money. So check carefully all the eligibility criteria, including what age, the degree, what you're applying for, and your professional experience. Sometimes they require this, and many other things that may be necessary for you to meet. Then you go to the third step, in which you have to check the scholarship coverage. In this case, you have to make sure that the scholarship meets what you expect from it. Some scholarships, for example, they cover only 50% of the tuition fees. Some of them cover every cost, including the flight tickets. So if you need a full scholarship, for example, and the scholarship covers only 50% of the tuition fees, or it doesn't cover the tuition fees, so this scholarship is not for you. Okay, so please check the scholarship coverage. But the other thing that's very important for you to make sure that it's covered or not, besides the coverage of the scholarship, you have to check the policies. Some scholarships, for example, don't allow you to work if you are on scholarship. Or there are many other things that you have to check before you submit your application, because it might not go through the point that you need from a scholarship. So the fourth step is to check the required documents and the deadline. At this point, I will emphasize especially the language tests. Some universities, for example, they require TOEFL, okay? And the deadline, for example, you have only 15 days. It means that for you to take TOEFL, it's impossible in 15 days. So in this case, this scholarship is not for you. But if you see that the scholarship is not for you, it's not just to quit. You have to send this scholarship, you have to recommend the scholarship to someone else. Maybe there's someone else who has the TOEFL test. So this person may apply or may be interested in applying to the scholarship. So don't just leave it. Okay, recommend someone else. And if you see that the scholarship, you have all the documents, or you can collect all the documents on time, then move to the next step, which is step 5, where you will check the application process. Application process is very important because some scholarships require you to send the applications, online, by email. Others, you have to mail them the hard copies. For example, most of the Chinese universities require this. And other scholarships are online. You have to submit through an online platform. So If it's online platform, this one I think they are always better because you don't need to spend a lot of money to submit your application. Okay, but you always need to check this. And why? One of the most important thing that that makes me believe that this is one of the important point is the money. Because some people start the application process and then they don't have enough money to send the application to the university or the scholarship agency. So in this case, it's useless for you to waste your time doing this process, all this process, and then not send the application because you will fail anyways. Then the sixth step is to learn about the selection process. Here, you have to know if the selection process is only documental or they will ask you for an interview. If this interview will be online or in person, or even some scholarships can ask you to take some written tests. So all these steps you have to be sure about them, because if you start the application process, you have to make sure that you'll go through till the end. Otherwise, it's useless. Okay, you waste your money, you waste your time, and it will be boring, and you will even end up not doing anything else because you'll be thinking about the failure that you have had for applying for this scholarship. So please make sure about all these things. The seventh step is to collect the application documents. In this case, I would recommend you to start from the most difficult documents to get. What kind of documents are those ones? References first, because you'll need someone else to write these references for you, and the person will need time. The second document that's very important is the passport. The passport, because the issuing agencies, they take long time sometimes. For example, in Mozambique, they need 15 days for you to get it. And if the scholarship has only, you have only 15 days to submit, then this passport can delay your process and submit the application late. And in this case, they won't even consider application. And the other thing is the medical checkup, okay? Because you need time to take all the medical tests for you to submit together with the other application documents. And the other thing that's very important is the essay. Some scholarships ask only one essay, but others they have many essays. And what's the most important thing in this essay is that you have to ask someone else to read your essay after you draft it. So please don't submit applications with grammar mistakes, spelling mistakes, and many other kind of mistakes that that may even underrate your application. So please make sure that you have all the things on time, and for that you have to study as early as possible. And then we have the eighth step, which is to prepare the essays. Okay, and as I said, you have to ask someone after you draft the essays, then ask someone to read it. Okay, because this person will make sure that firstly, you don't have so many grammar mistakes. Secondly, if the essays meet the criteria that's required for the essays, okay, for this particular scholarship or the program that you're applying for. And after that, the last step is to submit your application. You have to check item by item. If you have all of them in your scholarship set, I mean, application set of documents or not. Imagine, for example, if you prepare your application, you have all the documents, and then you forget only one, which is the most important. If you forget to submit this, unfortunately, you will fail. So please make sure that you have all the documents. I will suggest you to make a kind of checklist. So when you're about to submit, you will check each item, okay? And then you submit your application. Some people, for example, they mess up where online applications, they forget to click submit after they upload all the documents. So I hope you won't make this mistake. Make sure that you click submit after you attach all the documents and then wait for the result. The result may be what? Invitation for interview. Ask for you to submit an additional document, or even the final result of selection that you were, you were accepted or you were rejected for this scholarship program. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to subscribe and share with your friends, your family members, your relatives, and for them to watch this, because I believe that it's important, okay, for someone who seeks a scholarship. Thank you very much, and see you in the next video.